GSoft 2 is the quickest and easiest way to set up and configure your GS20 drive. Let's do an example. Download and install the free GSoft 2 application from the Automation Direct website. Plug a USB cable into the PC and the other end into the USB port of your GS20 drive. The USB cable will power the display, and you can even modify parameters. But you need to apply power to the drive to actually use it, so we'll apply power to the drive and wait for it to come up. Bring up the software and click on Connect. If you go to the Windows Device Manager on your PC, you'll see something that looks like this. Looks like my USB port ended up on this COM port. Yours will probably be different. So we should enter that here, but I'm not going to do that yet. Click on this COM test button to verify you have the correct connection. Oops, something went wrong. Well, we haven't selected the correct COM port yet, right? Let's do that now and try the test again. Ah, much better. Things look good, so let's connect to the drive. That takes a few seconds, so I'll fast forward the video. Down here we have a green light telling us we're connected. Ignore this protocol stuff. That only applies to non-USB drives. Click on the parameters button, and then click Read to fetch all of the parameters from the drive. Green parameters can be written to while the motor's running. Blue parameters can only be written to when the motor's not running. And black parameters are read-only parameters. Now this line's important. It tells us we're currently looking at the drive parameters, not the parameters read from the computer. Which drive GSoft 2 is working with, and a reminder to hit the Read button to update the current drive parameters. If I reach over to the drive and change parameter 0.04 to a 2, and hit Read, give it a few seconds, sure enough, we see the new parameter. It's red because it's not a default value. I love that I can quickly see what's different just by looking for the red parameters. You can also see what the min and max allowable values are for each parameter. Now, writes on the other hand happen instantly. For example, let's change that user display back to a 3, and as soon as I hit return or even just click away from that cell, the drive gets updated. And look down here. There's a running log that tells us everything we've done since the last read from the drive. If I do another read, that log gets cleared out. Once you have the parameters the way you want them, you can save them to your hard drive. We want to save the table from the drive to the disk. Enter our file name and do it. Now I can open that disk file, which is an Excel spreadsheet, by the way, and that appears down here. So these are the parameters from the drive, and these are the parameters from the disk file. And look up here. We're currently modifying the file parameters, not the drive parameters. It's really important that you keep an eye on this guy to make sure you're editing the correct set of parameters. Let's change that same parameter back to a 2. The drive didn't change because we're not editing the drive parameters. But we can write the file parameters to the drive by clicking Write. We can deselect any parameters we don't want to write and then hit the Write button. When it's done, we see the Write Summary page where it tells us everything that was written and any parameters that didn't get successfully written. So save, open, and new are disk file operations. Read and write are drive operations. The Rating button is to change the drive rating type in the file parameter set. For example, if I have a 1-horsepower GS20 configured exactly the way I want it, I can download that configuration file into a 2-horsepower GS20 by simply clicking this button and changing the drive rating in the file. Finally, this Compare button is a great feature. It allows you to do a side-by-side comparison between the parameters read from the drive and the parameters read from the saved disk file. If I read my current drive parameters and save those to disk, and then open that same file, then the drive and file parameters should be identical. So if we do a compare, we get this. It shows us all the drive parameters that are not defaults, all the file parameters which are not defaults, and the difference between the two, which since we haven't changed anything, is empty. I'll exit that and go select the drive parameters and change that same guy to a 7. Now if we do a compare, we see there's one difference between the saved file and the drive parameters. We could then write the drive parameters to the drive or save them to the disk if we want to. This is a virtual keypad. It's like using the optional GS4 keypad, which we have a separate video on, so you have to make sure that the local or remote configurations are set to use the RS-45 as their source for frequency and operation. The grayed out buttons aren't active, but you can run, change direction and stop the drive, and change the frequency. You can also jog the drive by clicking here. You have to hit the stop button to stop jogging. Well, that ought to be enough to get you started with GSoft 2. But there are some other really cool features built into this software, like the ability to view signals in real time and do firmware updates. We'll cover those in other videos. One final note. At the time I'm doing this video, GSoft 2 only works with the GS20 and GS4 drives. You'll still need the original GSoft application to configure GS1, 2, and 3 drives. The good news is, they're both free downloads at the AutomationDirect.com website. Click here to see all of the GS20 tutorial videos. Click here to learn about AutomationDirect's free support options, and click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.